this video, I will first talk a little bit about why content creation is an interesting learning approach. Then I will explain how the roles of students and the teacher in the learning process change when students become creators of their own content. After that, I will say a few words about how tablets support this process. Finally, I will give some tips on how to best organize the content creation process. Easy access to devices like tablets, social media, and different creative technologies have made it possible for basically anyone to create, reuse, and share content easily. In schools, students can use tablets to create content in different formats, like videos, presentations, posters, comics, audio files, storyboards, or even an app. Tablets enable students to access, create, and edit up-to-date educational resources, as opposed to traditional learning settings where content is static and developed by teachers or textbook authors. Students creating their own content serves several purposes. First, students can develop their understanding of the topic they create the content on. Second, students learn how to create their own content. By becoming producers, they learn about the processes and pitfalls of designing and creating content in an authentic, problem-solving context. It is important that the content creation process includes reflection on plagiarism, copyright, privacy issues, and online sharing. Third, creating one's own content can improve the student's motivation, participation, and achievement. This is in particular the case when outcomes are shared with a wider audience like parents, other teachers, and students. Possible channels for sharing are virtual learning environments or a dedicated student blog. When students create their own content, their role in the learning process becomes more active. Students act as creators, explorers, assessors, and presenters. To create their own content, they have to exercise their imagination and innovate. Students practice independent, self-organized learning, individually and in teams, or even at home as part of homework. At the end of the process, they showcase and present what they have created. Over time, students can develop their own learning portfolios containing all outputs they created. This learning portfolio can help them to link between disciplines and provide a real-life context to their classwork. In the content creation scenario, also your role as a teacher changes. As a teacher, you need to manage the process and to act as an advisor and specialist. Your role is particularly important in the beginning. You need to communicate to students the purpose of the digital content being created and set the goals and limits of the tasks. It can also be a good idea to agree together with students what the end product should be and produce a plan to get there, as well as to agree with students on possibly other teachers on quality criteria for the content. In addition, you can define available tools and pre-select information sources and other materials for students to use, and assign roles for the production team if needed. Don't forget that during the process, it will be important to support groups or individual students in doubt or with creative blocks. And at the end of the process, students might need help to publish and share the content. When students create their own content, they can use tablets at various stages of the process. In the explore phase, students can take the tablets outside of the classroom to collect information by taking pictures, recording video or audio interviews. They can use the tablets to conduct research online, take notes, collect, write and draw ideas, which later can be easily shared. In the make phase, students can use their tablets to create a huge variety of dynamic content such as digital books, animations, videos or presentations as an integral part of learning in new creative ways. In the ask phase, students can easily share interim results collected via the tablets by using blogs, e-portfolios or wikis. Finally, in the show phase, students can publish and showcase their final results via online learning environments and social media. Finally, I would like to share three tips on how to organize a successful content creation process. First, as time always becomes a very restrictive factor in content creation, targets should not be too ambitious. Smaller and less time-consuming learning resources combined with phases of reflection and discussion, will make the performance more predictable and motivating than complex content production processes. Second, ideally, the goal is an end product that fills a gap, is accessible, makes appropriate use of technology, and can be used and adapted by teachers and students. Third, it can be a good idea to give students a free choice of which mode of presentation and app they use, and encourage them to experiment with new tools to create creative outputs.